In this video, I'll be demonstrating anatomy of gluteus maximus, its origin, insertion, function, and I would like to describe the fascial connection of gluteus maximus. Gluteus maximus is one of the biggest muscle in the human body. Since this is very big muscle, origin is very broad. One part is here, this part is pelvis. It originates from ilium, and it also originates from sacrum and coccyx part. So it's like this region, ilium, sacrum, and coccyx. So since it originates from pelvis and sacrum, it crosses sacroiliac joint. So this muscle can be one reason for sacroiliac joint dysfunction. It's not the only the muscle, but this can be the reason for dysfunction. Gluteus maximus attaches on the fascia of muscle. Let's say like gluteus medius, fascia of gluteus medius, the fascia of erector spine, and some ligaments. There's a ligament here, sacrotuberous ligament. So not only the bones, gluteus maximus also has attachment with fascias. So this is very important point. And insertion is quite small compared to origin. It's here, gluteal tuberosity. Actually, this is a deep part of insertion. Actually, superficial part attaches on fascia of the thigh. I couldn't prepare for this model. This deeper part attaches on gluteal tuberosity. The superficial part, let's imagine it attaches on the fascia of the thigh. It's very important. The main function of gluteus maximus is very strong hip extensor. Extension is you pull leg this way, posteriorly. So when does gluteus maximus work? When you like you stand up, or when you squat, when you jump, when you run. This is very important muscle in daily life or sports, any kind of human activity. And one more thing, which is external rotation. External rotation is this way. Two movements, extension and external rotation. So this is the main part of gluteus maximus. I'd like to talk about the fascial connection of gluteus maximus. You see this red tape? This red tape represents the fascia of backside of the body. So this fascia is thoracolumbar fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia. Actually, thoracolumbar fascia is located in the middle part of the back and lower part of the back. I kind of demonstrate the one way, but it's kind of this way, intercrossing this way. So this part has connection with gluteus maximus. This is right side of gluteus maximus. And direction of gluteus maximus is like this way, right? And it attaches on the pelvis and sacrum this way. And the direction of thoracolumbar fascia is also this way and continues to the other side of the shoulder. And this becomes latissimus dorsi. Latissimus dorsi is very strong shoulder muscles on the back side of the shoulder. I will repeat again. This is right side of gluteus maximus. And the direction is this way, direction is this way, and it continues to thoracolumbar fascia. And thoracolumbar fascia becomes latissimus dorsi. So, right side of gluteus maximus has connection with left side of latissimus dorsi. It's like this way. This contralateral connection is very important. Contralateral means the other side. So, right side of gluteus maximus, left side of latissimus dorsi. This contralateral connection is important for especially walking or throwing motion. When you play sports, we usually do contralateral movement like running, right side back and left arm back, right? Contralateral part is pulling, right? So gluteus maximus, latissimus dorsi connection is so important to create the strong power. So in this video, I demonstrated the basic anatomy of gluteus maximus. It's very broad muscle, very strong muscle. It originates from pelvis, sacrum, and coccyx. And it kind of crosses sacroiliac joint, so this can be one reason for sacroiliac joint dysfunction. Also, it has fascial attachment with gluteus medius, erector spine, and sacrotuberous ligament. These connections are also important for pelvic movement. And function is extension, pull the leg back, and external rotation. The fascial connection, there is a connection with thoracolumbar fascia, then this becomes the other side of latissimus dorsi. This is very important for athletic movement. So this is today's video. If you liked it, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.